Hello and welcome to today's Daily Market Update with me, Josh Mahoney, Research Analyst here at Alpari UK. The major indices within Europe at the moment are pointing towards the upside, pairing some of the losses we've seen back in last week. Also, I think the fact that we've heard out of the US and that they're saying that they're not actually expecting to be moving into Iraq in terms of military action, that's a major step as well. Now, Iraq has been dominating affairs recently with the fact that we're seeing a spread of the ISIS group throughout the country. It does seem to be the case that the US is potentially going to be willing to talk to Iran and possibly work with them. I think the emphasis is going to be upon trying to push Iran into actually trying to take some sort of military action instead of the US. But it's definitely an ongoing situation which does have the potential to move the markets quite significantly. How it's going to play out in the future is yet to be seen, and how the actual military group that's moving across the country, killing many people as it goes, how they're planning to move ahead going forward also is an unknown completely. So it is a very liquid situation, so we're following that at the moment. Now, overnight in the markets, we did hear from the RBA with their minutes, and essentially it gave us much of the same, really. It was an indication that they expect to keep rates accommodative for a decent period of time. Now, this is to be expected, really. On the one side, we have a bit more of an emphasis more upon moving rates towards the upside. We've seen it in the likes of the New Zealand economy, and now we've seen an economy where essentially the housing prices are actually skyrocketing, much in the same way as the UK. But on the other side, I don't think they necessarily want to stifle the economy at a time when, you know, they haven't necessarily moved out of this period of downturn off the back of the weaknesses seen in China. So I think they're in that sort of period in the middle where we're actually going to see them remain pretty stationary for some period of time. So I don't think that their RBA statements and I don't think the minutes are really going to hold too much interest going forward. Now, also this morning out of the UK, we did hear from, we did see the CPI readings, the latest measure of inflation. The main CPI measure came in at 1.5, a significant drop from 1.8. And essentially what this means is that there's not too much to worry about in deflationary terms, in my opinion, because we still remain some way away. But what it does mean is that it puts less emphasis on the government to actually act and start raising rates anytime soon. And now tomorrow we're going to hear from the Bank of England in terms of their minutes and how they voted. And we're going to try and see whether the emphasis is upon them to actually raise rates sooner rather than later. And we did hear from Miles out of the Bank of England overnight or this morning, who essentially indicated that he expected to be raising rates sooner rather than later. So that's going to be interesting. It's also going to be interesting to see at the next meeting exactly how the CPI measure that we saw today impacts the thoughts within the Bank of England going forward. Now, also this morning, we did hear from the Eurozone in terms of the ZEW economic sentiment figures. This is generally split between Germany and the Eurozone as a whole. Now, essentially what we had was the forward-looking indicator or the forward-looking survey was the one that actually came in negatively. 6 months on the trot now that we've seen a deterioration in the German economic sentiment looking forward. Whereas we did actually see an uptick in the current situation, possibly in line with the fact that we saw Mario Draghi actually indicate that he was willing to do a lot, essentially, in terms of different policies to try and prop up the Eurozone economy and try and get inflation back in. It's a bit of a mixed bag this morning, but really I'm concentrating on the forward-looking indicator because we know where we are at the moment, but it's interesting to try and understand exactly what people think going forward for the future, and that's likely to also impact their decision making in terms of purchases and the like. Lastly, I just wanted to touch on tomorrow's FOMC meeting. It begins today and we're going to hear the announcement tomorrow. I do expect to see much of the same in terms of yet another $10 billion worth of tapering, but as we see some sort of resolution or advancements to the Iraq crisis at the moment, should we actually hear that there would be any sort of possibility of military action or financial backing from the US, then it's quite likely that we're going to see that reflected within the FOMC meetings. where they're going to potentially discuss it and see whether they need to hold off and remain more accommodative to prop up an economy that possibly might be losing some of its fiscal power to military spending that wasn't necessarily expected previously. So that's it for today, guys. If you want any more news and analysis, come and check out the Alpari newsroom at alpari.co.uk/newsroom or check me out on Twitter. My name is Joshua Mahoney, research analyst here at Alpari UK. Have a great day.